With that aside, let me go to how the system works with multiple access points. So let me restate the problem. One cell, one access point, multiple devices. As a function of the number of devices that are active, we estimate the number of instantaneous contenders. We manipulate the contention parameters appropriately, or all the WMM parameters appropriately. We advertise them. We have the ability to selectively advertise or individualize these parameters on a per device basis. We reduce collisions. We take a system that with any other vendor would go like this, and we make it go like this. Notice by design, it's not an exact straight line, almost a straight line. Now, you put a second access point right here. How does the system behave? If you did nothing, really bad things could happen. And the reason is each of these access points could be acting, you know, in isolation. And let's say this access point has only one device. It might advertise very low contention parameters, and it'll effectively take over the channel and kill all of these guys. Right? So notice that in a multi-access point scenario, whether you put these access points on the same channel or different channels, because you really don't have enough channels to effectively take away co-channel interference. So even if your neighboring access point doesn't contend with you, hey, some faraway access point might be. It is really important, in order to build a network that scales, to ensure that access points that are on the same channel understand the load on that channel, and then advertise or adjust these contention parameters appropriately. So the way we do that is that each access point advertises its load on each of these, you know, each of the different traffic classes. So every access point understands not only its own load, it understands the load in its entire neighborhood. Right? So for example, in this particular instance, the access point would say, I have five devices in my own cell, and I happen to see one device in my neighbor. If you have multiple neighbors, what you end up doing is you look at my load plus some function of all my neighbor's load. And this function really is interesting and to some extent offers the cue to how the system scales effectively, because this function is based on how we are able to interpret the collision resolution between multiple neighbors, and that's where a lot of our, you know, core work and proprietary algorithms are, you know, all the intellectual property of the company comes in, where we essentially have a global graph. We look at the kind of interference that we might see across multiple access points, and then pick this function that accurately reflects the contention that would be caused in this access point based on what everybody else provides. In the simplistic case, it's five of mine plus one of my neighbors. And for this guy, correspondingly, it's one of mine plus five of my neighbors. So notice that this access point behaves as though the load is six, not one. That ensures that this AP does not pick very aggressive values and kill this one. In fact, in this particular instance, they pick the same values. I hope this makes sense. So once we get to this point, notice that we look at the entire neighborhood and then pick these values and appropriately decide we are not really at this point, but in terms of effective number of contenders, we are here. Now, as a further nuance, this device might be not a data client, but a voice client, in which case the way these functions are chosen or the way the contention parameters are chosen per traffic class are not just dependent upon the traffic in that class, it is also dependent upon all the traffic in higher classes. And the point I'm trying to make here is, regardless of whether the voice client was in this access point or in this access point, the contention parameters for data will be chosen in order to reflect that. This is the way we minimize co-channel interference minimize collisions both within a particular access point and across access points. Thank you.